Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow.
Welcome once again to the Unified Church of Christ webcast. I'm Pastor Matthew Blair. I hope and pray that your week has been as good as mine or better. You know, I'm constantly reminded by the Lord of how much of a blessing being a servant of Jesus Christ is. It really truly is a blessing to be a servant to the Lord God. Amen? And I have, even through the hardest weeks, I have that blessing on me because I know that after all is said and done, I still have the Lord. I still have His favor. I still have His goodness in my life. Amen. And it's still, you know, it floors me. It really does. How good God really is. How wonderful He really is to us. You know, I'm not a very intelligent man. I know that some would argue, probably just because they're being nice. But I didn't do very well at school. And I don't remember a whole lot of my college. I still have problems with understanding this blessed word. I still have problems learning certain things. I have problems holding attention. As you might have seen from my sermons, I'm kind of a pastor for the underdog, so to speak, because I am living proof that people with ADHD and ADD can preach the Word of God because I squirrel. I have a severe problem with attention. My mind goes everywhere. And so I have to really try to stay focused. But praise God that the sermons actually go through because the Holy Spirit guides me through the whole process. He guides me through the whole thing. And though my sermons may not always make 100% clear sense, they usually come through on a certain point, and it usually gets to the heart. Amen? And I'm telling you right now, if you're affected by my sermons at all, if there's anything that at any time when I'm preaching, if there's any part of that sermon that affects you, it's not because of Matthew. I can assure you of that. It's not because of my intelligence or because of my knowledge. It's because of the Holy Spirit that guides and manifests Himself inside of me and puts Himself out there so that you can learn and so that you can get something out of my teaching. And I just praise God because, you know, I'm one of those people that are like Moses. You know, Moses, He said he had a problem, a speech impediment, you know, and he had a problem standing before people. And it was probably a nervous problem, probably a little bit. It's kind of hard for me to imagine that he had a nervous problem, him being in the house of the Pharaoh. But for Moses to say, Lord, how are you going to use me? Because I don't have a perfect tongue. I can't speak well. I don't asphyxiate words properly. I don't pronunciate very well. So how are you going to use me with my faltering lips? And God, what did God tell Moses? Who created the human mouth? Who created the tongue that it should speak? The Lord God created the tongue. The Lord God created our human mouths. He gave us the ability for speech. So why do we hold back when we know that God is able to bring forth something great out of something poor? Someone awesome out of something low. You know, I was going to preach on something else tonight, but I have a feeling that this is where God wants me to preach, right here. There are a few of you out there, there's probably a lot of you out there, actually. I know I'm one of them, who don't feel like you're adequate enough, who don't feel like you could be important, don't feel like that you could actually achieve anything. You're kind of the low man on the totem pole, so to speak. I don't believe in totem poles because, well, I've heard bad things about them. No offense to you Native Americans out there. I've got Native in me. But totem pole, I've heard, is, you know, some kind of religious thing anyway. It looks kind of like an idol to nature. But I haven't done any study on that. But anyway, again, that's my ADD thing, getting off the subject. You seem probably like the low man on the totem pole. You seem like the one that is sitting under everybody else, and everybody else is kind of pushing off of you to get to the top, right? If I'm speaking to that person, hello, how are you? My name's Matt. I'm right there with you. I'm right there with you at the bottom of that totem pole. But I tell you what, God, if you're a Christian and you're feeling that way, I've got some great news for you, brothers and sisters. I've got some great news for you. Jesus said we are the head and not the tail. We are the head and not the tail. You know what that means? We are the top of the totem pole, not the bottom. We're not the one holding people. Well, you know what? It probably isn't so bad to be at the bottom of the totem pole. It has its importance because those are the ones who are holding up the others, right? I mean, that's kind of what we do, right? Well, that's what we should do. Hold up the others. Amen? That's what God assigns us to do, is hold people up. Okay? And if you're not doing your part in holding people up, then you should. You should. But we spend so much time being the low man on the totem pole, being the tail. We spend so much time thinking of ourselves as being low to the ground, dirt, nothing, nobodies, you know, not going to achieve anything, doesn't matter. We're, you know, nobody would care if I died, so to speak. Okay? We spend so much time in that mode that we don't realize what the Word of God says about that. That we are important. That we are important to God. That we're important to His plan. You know, Gideon, I'm reminded of Gideon. Okay, Gideon was a man who thought that God couldn't use him. He thought, who am I? I'm just Gideon. You know, I'm just a dude. How could God use Gideon? But God said, I'm going to use you, Gideon. And I'm going to make you like a judge. I'm gonna put you in charge of Israel. I'm gonna make you the leader, buddy. Well, this guy, you know, this guy was like me and you. This guy was low. This guy was his self-esteem was just, I mean, it was low. And Gideon was like, I'm nothing, God. I'm nobody. You got a nobody from Nobody'sville. You know what I mean? Nobody'sville. Okay? That's what Gideon was. He was a no one from no one'sville. And God sent his angel to tell Gideon, I'm going to use you. I'm going to use you for a greater purpose than just being Gideon. Because to God, just being Gideon is more than enough. Just being Matthew is more than enough. Just being Madeline is more than enough. Just being Michael or Jeffrey or Anna or Daphne or whoever you are out there is more than enough. And you know why? Because if you apply this, the holy word of God, his truth, his living, breathing word, if you apply this to who you are, this is like a battery pack for no ones. You put this thing in here, in your mind. You put it right here in your heart. Guaranteed. Guaranteed. That word is going to pierce you. That word is going to penetrate you. That word is going to lift you up to the heights of the heavens and bring you before the throne of God, allowing you to be approached by the Father himself and being brought to that place of anointing where that strong anointing is going to push you forth and make you believe in yourself for once in your life. And I'm telling you right now, to all of you out there who are not Christians, this message is for you as well. Because at the end of this sermon, at the end of this lesson, I'm going to give an invitation for you all to come and join the family and embrace Jesus Christ. And for once in your life, if you're a nobody, you put this into play, and you're going to be a somebody. You're going to be a somebody. You know, there's a commercial out there. It has Pinocchio on it. Some of you might have all seen it. You know what I'm talking about? Pinocchio? It has Pinocchio on it, and he's an inspirational speaker. And he's looking out in the audience, and there's some of these people. And we know the story of Pinocchio, you know, when he lies, his nose grows. Well, he's out there, he's going, you know, I'm standing before you here today, and I see potential. You have potential, and you have potential. Oh, boy. And his nose starts to grow because he knows he's lying, and those people don't have potential. Well, I'm telling you right now the opposite of that. You know, and if I was Pinocchio, my nose could grow when I lie. I tell you right now, my nose would not grow because I tell you the truth. Without this holy word, you may not have any potential. As a matter of fact, you probably don't. And the reason for that is because whatever you do is fruitless. Without the holy word of God, and without the spirit of the truth living inside of you, without the Holy Spirit living inside of you, without the message of the Lord God Almighty, without his son Jesus, you have absolutely no potential. Now, a lot of you out there are going, wow, that is harsh. It is harsh, but it's a harsh, true reality. Without God, without Jesus, the Son of God, the Christ, you have absolutely no potential whatsoever. Because everything you do and everything you've done and everything you're going to do in life amounts to nothing. That's what Solomon said. I looked at it all, and it is dust in the wind. It is nothing. It amounts to nothing. It is here today and gone tomorrow into the wind. It is like a flower that grows beautiful in the field and then the next day it withers away. It amounts to nothing. But I'm telling you, friends, with this, with the Word of God, with Jesus Christ, that flower can last forever. 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 How would you like to be a flower that lasts forever? Now, a lot of you people looking at me going, I'm not a flower. No, but you are beautiful. You are beautiful. And I personally don't want to see that beauty decay. I personally do not want to see all of that potential, all of that wondrous. You see, the Bible says we were made in the image of God. And I see it. I see it. I don't care how hideous you think you look. I don't care what caused you to be hideous, if that's what you think you are, is hideous. You are beautiful in the sight of God. You are incredible in the sight of God because you were made in his beloved image. Made in his image. Isn't Isn't that awesome? That is so awesome. We were made and molded in the image of the Almighty God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You know, to be aware that you are beautiful. You don't have to have man's approval. You don't have to go and date men to be beautiful. You don't have to, man, sir, you don't have to go and date women to be beautiful. You don't have to get the approval of mankind, because you have already gotten the approval right there, right here, in this blessed word. You have gotten the approval of the Lord God Almighty. He said, I have made you in my image. Praise God. You are already loved. You are already approved. You don't need the approval of man. You don't need my approval. You don't need your mother's approval. You don't need your father's approval, your friend's approval, your husband's approval, your son's or daughter's approvals. You don't need your aunts or uncles or wives' approval. You don't need it. You need God's approval, and that is it. That is it. So friends, if you're out there and you're watching this, and I know that some of you are feeling that way, unimportant, unwanted, and there might be some of you out there who are actually thinking about just ending it all, just getting rid of this life and just committing suicide, getting it over with. I'm telling you right now, stop what you're doing. Don't think about it. Just know right now. Right now, I want you to know how beautiful you are. How wonderful you are. You know, the Bible says you are fearfully and wonderfully made. You know, I watched a video earlier today on Facebook. I imagine somebody had posted it to YouTube or something, but it was this young, beautiful young girl. And she had been burnt. I won't mention her name in case she doesn't want it mentioned. But she had been burnt. And she was talking about how at first she was picked on and everybody wouldn't, you know, had trouble looking at her. And when they did look at her, they stared. And it was just horrible, you know, what this young lady experienced. And she didn't feel beautiful. She didn't feel like she was important because of the way she was, because she got third-degree burns, and she was feeling like she was just disgusting. And so far from the truth. So far from the truth. Well, later on, she realized, after the inspiring words of her mom, she realized, because her mom told her, don't hide those scars. Place them for the world to see. Those are your beauty marks. So she realized that she was beautiful, no matter what. And I'm telling you right now, no matter what you look like, no matter where you came from, no matter where you live, no matter you know, how many times you were abused, one, that's not your fault. Two, it doesn't matter anymore. I want you to look at this screen right now, and I want you to look at me as if I was you. And I want you to say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I didn't see myself as beautiful. Then, after this sermon's over, I want you to get down on your knees. And I want you to ask God to forgive you of your sins and to bring Jesus into your life. And I want you to go into the bathroom or into your bedroom or wherever you have a mirror, and I want you to look at yourself and you say these words: I am made in the image of God, and I am beautiful. I don't care who you are out there. I don't care what you've been through. You are beautiful to God. This message is intended for you. Because like I said, tonight I was going to preach on something different, but God led me to that place to where I'm telling you right now how important you are. And you know, you're asking yourself, Pastor, Okay, you say I'm important. But what am I going to do with my life? Well, it depends. What do you want to do with your life? Do you want to live your life for yourself? Do you want to live your life for others? Do you want to live your life for God? If you live your life for God, then everything else will fall into place. But you need to give yourself over to Him. I'm not saying be a slave. God doesn't want slaves. He wants children. I'm not saying that you've got to put bracelets on your arms or your legs and be a slave. I'm saying be a child of God. Embrace the light. Have you ever heard that expression before? Embrace the light. Because you know where that came from? Embrace the light. Come out of darkness. Come out of darkness and embrace the light. Bring it to you. And that's what I'm asking right now, is that you'll just give God a chance to show you how important you are. You know, the ministry of Jesus Christ has so many positions. There's prophets, preachers, teachers. If you're a parent, you're doing the ministry. If you're an uncle or an aunt, has nieces and nephews, and you bring the word of God to them, you inspire them by living, just being who you are in Christ, then you're being a minister. I heard this preacher on the radio on, I believe it was Kayla the other day, saying, God has given parents the opportunity to be ministers. You have a constant audience. And it's true. You have a constant audience. And there is no more precious an audience than your own children. Amen? So if you're a parent, you have a very important ministry. If you're an uncle or aunt, you have a very important ministry. If you are a person who works out in the public, you have an important ministry. Live your life. Live your life for Christ. And show them the light. And they'll see that in you. But right now, I want you to really focus on the fact that you are important. That God made you in His image, and that you are beautiful, that you are important, that you're He is ready to use you. But you have to be available. You have to be available. You know, I hate to use this in an analogy, but having a personal relationship with Christ is a lot like dating. Because Jesus has always got His profile up. He's always got His profile ready for viewing. All you have to do is view it and respond. Respond. Then what's going to happen? You're going to get a response right back. There's a guy who was on, I believe it was America's Got Talent. And I later on checked him out on YouTube. And God bless you, sir, because it was very catchy and got in my head for weeks. He got this song called God Answered My Friend Request. You know, God Answered My Friend Request. Yes. Yes, God Answered My Friend Request. And he pressed like. That guy. Anyway, so God is always ready. He's always ready to respond. He's always ready to answer your friend requests. And He'll hit like on your profile. Guaranteed. Jesus loves you so much. How much does He love you? Everyone should know this. And if you don't, you're about ready to find out. Jesus loves you this much. John 3:16. I'm going to go there in case some of you don't know. This world has kind of departed from the Word of God, so maybe some people out there actually don't know what John 3:16 is. And I'm about ready to reveal it to you. And praise God that I am able to do this in the God-blessed United States of America, where we still have religious freedom. Amen? John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world." What world? Earth. Our world. He loved the world. Now, does that mean he loved everything in the world? Yes. But he so loved the world. That's the inhabitants of this planet. He so loves us. For God so loved the world that he gave. He gave. What did he give? His only begotten Son. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And a lot of people don't know this, verse 17. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that through him we might be saved. How beautiful is that? How beautiful is that? That Jesus not only has a killer dating profile, he has the best relationship status in the world. And he's able and ready to make that available to you. As a matter of fact, it is ready and available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, all holidays. All you have to do is click on it. Open it up. Breathe it in. Soak it up. And then know that Jesus is ready to receive you as his own. Now you will have a personal relationship with Jesus, and now you really don't have to worry about anything, because once you have that personal relationship, as long as you always have that personal relationship with Jesus, you never have to worry about anyone else's approval, about whether or not you're important, about whether or not you're beautiful, about whether or not you are worth something, because you will always have God's approval. Always. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that beautiful, friends? Oh, God bless, that's beautiful. We always have his approval as long as we're walking faithfully with him. And how does he say to walk faithfully with him? If you love me. Now, what did Jesus say? If you love me, what? If you love me, you will keep my commandments. How hard is that? Commandments 1 through 10. Thou shalt not. Okay? You don't plan on murdering anybody, do you? You don't plan on stealing, lying. But if you do, all you have to do is repent and ask God to forgive you. He's faithful to forgive. If you've done all that stuff in your past, don't even worry about it right now. Because he has forgiven. If you've accepted Jesus Christ, here's the good news. He has wiped your slate clean. He has tossed your sins into the sea of forgetfulness, never to be remembered again. The Bible says, though a man sins 77 times 7 in a day, he is to be forgiven. That's a lot of sin. But I tell you what, God is faithful. He will get you through it. I'm gonna try. If the Holy Spirit doesn't have another message for me, I'm gonna try to preach on that next week. Please stay tuned for next week's message on the once in grace, always in grace theory. Okay? And I know a lot of people will probably stay in tune just so they can comment on my page and criticize my teaching. But you know what? It's not my teaching. Like I said before, I have a serious ADD problem. It's not my teaching. It's God's teaching. If you don't like it, take it up with him. Take it up with him. And for crying out loud, if I'm going against the word, please pray for me. Because I want to do what is in this word. I want to do what's right. I want to be guided by the Holy Spirit and by the Holy Word. So if I strayed from the doctrine in any of my teachings, please pray for me. And beloved, you are more than welcome to make a comment on the page and tell me, Pastor, here's where you went wrong. Let me tell you, this is actually in the Bible, not that. Okay, I will listen as long as it's in the King James Version of the Bible. I don't believe in the New Living Testament. I don't believe in the New International. I don't believe in any of those versions. I believe in the King James only. I'm a King James only preacher. You can thank Pastor Mike Hoggard for that. I love that guy. Bethel Church in Missouri. in the United States. But I just want to also give a shout out to my Royals going to the series. I think that's awesome. First time since 1985. I've supported the boys in blue for as long as I can remember. So doesn't matter how bad they were, I still love them. And that, you know, that's how Jesus is. He loves you no matter how much you falter, how much you fall, because eventually you're gonna rise back up again. You're gonna get there. And praise God, we will get there. So beloved, this is the part of the program where I give you the opportunity. If you have not received Jesus Christ, you can do so right now. I'm going to give you the opportunity. So if you would bow your head with me and say these words, Father God, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the everlasting God. I believe that He died. I believe that He rose again and that He is seated at your right hand, Father. I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Fill me with your Holy Spirit now and make me free. I believe, Lord Jesus. Now come in me and cleanse me. Make me whole. I denounce the works of Satan. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Friends, if you prayed that prayer, oh, I want to know about it. You don't have to let me know, but I really like to know because I really want to pray for you. And I want to make sure that we walk together circumspectfully in a circle. Amen. Constantly coming back to the Word of God. Always coming back to the Word of God because that's our instruction. The Bible, a lot of people say, means basic instructions before leaving Earth. But anyway, like I said, stay tuned next time for the Once in Grace, Always in Grace. And until next time, I love you. We all love you. And most importantly, Jesus loves you. Have a blessed and wonderful week.